Mr. Zomer is someone who has impacted many lives of people who have gone through the education system here at Brush Schools.
Mr. Zomer was a sub here at Brush School District. He is now moving to Arizona.
We would like to have a proper send-off to one of our favorite subs, so here are some messages from students and staff.
How did you meet Mr. Zomer?
I met Mrs. Zomer sixth grade year because our teacher left, and he substituted for our whole class for like 4 months straight.
I met Mr. Zomer probably in the third or fourth grade when he was a sub.
He was a substitute, and I went to school in Brush, so he was here one day, and I taught here in Brush too, and ever since then you kind of just, I don't know, he's kind of a legend around here. Like, everyone just knows Zomer. You know, you just tell a kid, you know Zomer, and they know him because he subs everything from high school to, I think, Thompson. So growing up, you've run into him at one point in time.
I met Mr. Zomer when he substituted for us for like many months during seventh grade when my reading teacher quit, and he was the only sub that substituted for us until like the end of the year when we actually got a new teacher.
I met Mr. Zomer actually in the 1980s when I worked at a radio station called KKGZ, which is literally down the road here. And he gave me my first job to work for him, and I started radio broadcasting all because of him. So I am where I am at today on the broadcasting side because of Mr. Zomer.
As him being my sub, he was the best sub that I've ever had. The very first day, him coming in, and he actually would rehearse my bands and let them make noise, and that's not normal for a sub, so that's how I met Mr. Z.
Mr. Zomer was our sixth grade writing teacher.
So I met Mr. Zomer here at work. He also was subbing here, and all I know is this. When I first started, all I heard was Mr. Zomer this, Mr. Zomer that. Everybody loved Mr. Zomer, and I will tell you, he had some big shoes for me to fill, and I have not yet filled them. I don't know if I will ever fill them, but I know this. He is so loved by the students and staff that, you know what, one day I hope that people feel about me working here as they feel about him.
Favorite thing about Mr. Zomer?
My favorite thing about Mr. Zomer is how he takes his wife every Friday to get ice cream. Every Friday. That's true love right there.
Zomer.
That he wrote in all capital letters, and he told us about his granddaughters, Apple and Peaches, all the time. And he was just so willing to share his life with us. He told us about his dates with his wife all the time.
There are a lot of them. The way he dresses, he's always professional. The way that he approaches kids, he loves kids.
My favorite thing about Mr. Zomer is his professionalism. He's very good with what he does.
He's just always so positive, and he works so well with the kids, and he loves to rehearse them, and he loves to teach them things besides what's just left for them. He's not your typical sub that likes to just sit back. He likes to be involved in working with the students.
My favorite thing about Mr. Zomer is just his personality. I think he comes across to a lot of people like he's, you know, because he's such a great guy, and his kindness shows every time that he's around people.
That the kids love him. I'll have like former students come up to me and ask me, hey, is Mr. Zomer still subbing? Like, that's what they ask me. They don't ask me how I'm doing. They ask me how Mr. Zelmer's doing. So the kids love Mr. Zomer.
There's lots. I think one of my favorites is he always comes dressed up in his suit, whether he's subbing for me or for the PE teacher. He'll wear a hat if he's subbing for PE, but he always comes dressed as if like he's, you know, takes it seriously, and he's looking for like an interview in a way. Like, he always comes very important, and I always admired that, just because, like I said, if I were to do PE, I'd come in here in like sweats and some shorts or something, and he always comes dressed up, and he does that whether it's a high school class or a middle school class, you know, elementary. He always kind of carries that same importance no matter what he's subbing for.
Okay.